He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted.
Me ha enviado a sanar a los quebrantados de corazón.
To preach deliverance to the captives.
A pregonar libertad a los cautivos.
And recovering of sight to the blind.
Vista a los ciegos.
To set at liberty them that are bruised.
A poner en libertad a los oprimidos.
And I want to preach today.
Y quiero predicar hoy día.
Maybe I should say I'm going to preach, but I'm also going to teach.
Quiero hoy día sí voy a predicar, pero también quiero enseñar.
On the purpose of God's anointed people.
En el propósito del pueblo ungido de Dios.
So you may be seated.
Entonces pueden tomar sus asientos.
Throughout this week.
A través de esta semana.
Through various methods.
A través de varios métodos.
Maybe I should say more correctly, through people I have met.
A través, diría mejor correctamente, a través de personas que he conocido.
Or situations that I have heard of.
O situaciones de las que he escuchado.
I have come to the conclusion.
He venido a la conclusión.
That deliverance.
Que liberación.
Is God's plan.
Es el plan de Dios.
For the time that we are living in.
Para el tiempo en el que estamos viviendo.
This hour.
Esta hora.
This moment.
Este momento.
Is God's plan.
Es el plan de Dios.
That there are things that God wants to give to people.
Que hay cosas que Dios quiere dar a su pueblo.
But there are hindrances.
Pero hay cosas que les retienen.
There are things that get in the way.
Hay cosas que se ponen en el camino.
And we must have deliverance.
Y debemos tener liberación.
In the church.
En la iglesia.
So if you were to turn to Isaiah 61.
Si usted voltea a Isaías capítulo 61.
And just a few things I want to say.
Y algunas cosas que quiero decir.
I'm still going to. We're going to do that song at the end, Brother Prince.
Vamos a hacer la alabanza al final, Brother Prince.
I don't think it will be lengthy.
No creo que va a ser largo hoy día.
But I do feel.
Pero sí siento.
That today.
Que hoy día.
Has a divine appointment from God.
Es una cita divina por Dios.
And I believe that God chooses the people who. I think he draws many people.
Yo creo que Dios alcanza o llama.
But not everyone is able to fight through some of the resistance.
Pero no todos pueden pelear a través de las resistencias.
I think when someone is being pulled by the Spirit.
Creo que cuando alguien ha sido jalado por el Espíritu.
I think we have evidence in the Scripture.
Creo que tenemos evidencia en la Escritura.
That the enemy is working to resist.
Que el enemigo está trabajando para resistir.
That work of God.
Aquella obra de Dios.
Not just in the life of God's people.
No solo en la vida del pueblo de Dios.
But to those who are being called even today.
Pero aquellos que están siendo llamados hoy día.
And so there is a work of the Spirit going on.
Entonces hay una obra del Espíritu que está sucediendo.
And I feel a divine direction.
Y yo siento una dirección divina.
And I believe that there are two things that are important.
Y yo creo que hay dos cosas que son importantes.
The first revelation.
La primera revelación.
That we must have.
Que nosotros debemos tener.
Is the revelation of who God is.
Es la revelación de quién Dios es.
That he is not one of the gods.
Que no solo es uno de los dioses.
That there aren't others next to him sharing his power.
Que no hay otros a las de él compartiendo su
but
poder.
But hear, O Israel.
Pero he aquí Israel.
The Lord our God is one.
El Señor nuestro Dios uno es.
That is to say, hear my people of God.
Aquí nos dice, oh mi pueblo de Dios.
There's only one God.
Solo hay un solo Dios.
That is the first revelation.
Esa es la primera revelación.
It's important that you know we are serving a true living God.
Es importante.
importance
de la importancia
of that revelation.
De esta revelación.
And yet it's on that revelation
y aún así en esa revelación
that God has chosen to build his church.
Que Dios ha escogido edificar a su iglesia.
Jesus said,
Jesús nos dijo,
upon this rock,
sobre esta roca,
I will build my church.
Edificaré mi iglesia.
That the importance is that you know,
la importancia es que usted sepa,
this is the first revelation,
y esta es la primera revelación,
that will empower you,
que le va a empoderar,
to overcome all spiritual darkness.
Para poder vencer todas las tinieblas espirituales.
Is that there is only one God.
Es que hay un solo Dios.
That God is a spirit,
que Dios es un espíritu,
according to John 4:24.
De acuerdo a Juan capítulo 4:24.
And that God, who is a spirit,
y que Dios, que es un espíritu,
was the creator of all things.
Fue el creador de todas las cosas.
And in order to become our Savior,
pero para convertirse en nuestro Salvador,
that God,
ese Dios,
came in the form of a man.
Vino en una forma de hombre.
He was born of a virgin.
Y nació de una virgen.
Whose name was Mary.
Que su nombre era María.
When the angel came and told her,
cuando el ángel vino y le dijo,
her response made it possible.
Su respuesta lo hizo posible.
She said, even as you have said, let it be.
Ella dijo, como tú has dicho, así sea.
It's still the same.
Aún es lo mismo.
Revelation comes to empower his people.
La revelación viene para empoderar a su pueblo.
But your response to the revelation,
pero la manera que tú respondes,
will determine,
va a determinar,
whether you will be empowered by that revelation.
Y usted va a poder ser empoderado por esa revelación.
God
able
to do exceedingly,
hacer
abundantly,
mucho más,
above all,
sobre todo,
that we can think or ask,
que nosotros podamos pedir,
according to the power,
al poder,
that worketh in us,
que obra dentro de nosotros.
It's not by the design of man.
No es por el diseño del hombre.
It's not by our skills, talents, or abilities.
No es por nuestros talentos.
But it is by the power of the Spirit of our God. That revelation is the cornerstone, the foundation of all that will and has ever been accomplished in the church. It is not God's plan,
no es el plan de Dios,
that the church will be weak,
que la iglesia sea débil,
anemic,
o anímica,
powerless,
sin poder,
distracted by the world,
distraída por el mundo,
nor would his church buy into this world,
que se compren a este mundo,
it's going to be a separated people,
sino que va a ser una iglesia separada,
separated by divine revelation.
Separada.
It's the revelation working in the heart that changes the way we live. I am not serving some God who is out there,
who is
involved in a team of gods, but I am serving the one true living God. Another power to come and live inside of me, or inside of you, but the creator of the universe became a man, lived and died, was buried and rose again in order to come back and live inside of us. That is the revelation of the one true God. That is the first revelation that is necessary. And you cannot buy,
you
concepts of this world.
Usted no puede entrar en los conceptos de
este mundo. Money cannot buy the church.
El dinero no puede comprar a la iglesia.
Skills, talents, abilities.
Talentos, habilidades.
Of human wisdom.
Esta sabiduría humana.
Cannot produce the church of the living God.
No puede producir en la iglesia
de Dios. When God saw the need of the world.
Cuando Dios miró la necesidad del mundo.
He gave to us the divine plan. I am with you.
Yo estoy contigo.
But I shall be in you.
Pero estaré dentro de ti.
That's what empowers us.
Eso es lo que nos empodera.
The Creator.
El Creador.
Becoming the Savior.
Convirtiéndose en el
Salvador. To live inside of us.
Para poder
morar dentro de ti. He redeemed us. He redeemed us.
Él nos ha redimido.
That means He paid the price for you. You become His property. Which brings me to the second revelation. Now let me assure you. According to God's word. Flesh and blood. Will not give you the first or the second revelation. You won't get the revelation. Just because you are educated.
No vas a recibir la revelación.
You won't get the revelation.
No vas a recibir la
just because you're born an apostolic.
Porque has nacido un apostólico.
You must have a relationship with Jesus Christ that is intimate. That is close. So He can reveal Himself to you.
Creator
can create the desire where there is no desire. God speaks all languages.
Dios habla todas las lenguas.
It doesn't matter what color your skin is.
No importa qué color tu piel.
It doesn't even matter how bad your sins have been.
Y ni siquiera importa qué tan malos tu pecado.
God is greater than your sins.
Thank you.
the revelation of the mighty God in Christ. Now, how many of you know Lord Jesus Christ was not his name? Jesus is his name. But Lord is a title. Lord, he's the Lord. It meant like he's above all. He put all things under his feet. He's the Lord. And Christ, that is not his last name. Hello? The word Christ means the anointing. Jesus the Christ. Jesus, the anointed one. There might have been another Jesus in Jerusalem, but there was only one Jesus the Christ. He was the anointed one, chosen of God. This is important. This is called divine revelation. And it comes by the preaching of the word. I'm not having a spiritual debate with somebody here. I'm not arguing with you. I'm telling you, according to God's word, there's only one God.
Constantemente bombardeados por el diablo.
Even though God see God fulfilling His great plan in your life, you tend to become just religious. Go to church, pay your tithes. Say a hallelujah. Do whatever is asked of you around the church. But I want to preach for a few minutes. And I mean just a few minutes. Just a few minutes. That I'm convinced this revelation is what empowers the church. God is powerful, and I think we all can agree. There's nothing too hard for God. But the problem, I don't think, is with God. I think the problem is that we lack revelation of who we are in Christ. And today I'm preaching it because I believe we are on the verge of the greatest harvest the world has ever seen. He said in, I believe, 2 Peter 2:9, you are a chosen generation. You have been chosen by God. You got to get that revelation. You have been chosen by God. I don't care who your daddy is, who your mama is. Maybe you don't have one. I don't care where in that sense, where you came from. God doesn't want you to continue living like a victim. He wants you to live like the victor. He doesn't want you to live like a beat down, trodden down, stepped on. He wants you to be the head and not jobs where heathens are getting a better job than you. Hello, help me, Jesus. You're treading water. I'm convinced that part of it is this. You've got to get the revelation of who you are in Christ. Talking about if you're not educated for the job, or you don't just walk in there, you know, and demand the job, and you got no abilities. I'm talking about people, you have done all you can do. You're prepared for the job, and somebody even with less qualities step in front of you and get the job. Are y'all with me? Don't you think it's time for that to stop? Don't you think it's time? All right, I'm treading out here now. Folks will think I'm stepping. I don't preach like this. Let's talk about Israel, the name Israel. You know, God chose. He said, you're not going to be called Jacob anymore. That man, Jacob.
Ese hombre, Jacob.
Jacob means deceiver, cheat, thief.
Jacob significa ladrón.
And that's what Jacob was.
Y eso era lo que Jacob era.
But one day when he crossed the brook,
pero un día cuando él pasó el Jordán,
he had a little struggle. He had a big struggle. He had an encounter with God.
Él tuvo un encuentro con Dios.
It changed the way he walked.
Cambió la manera que él caminaba.
Listen, if you're going to be one of God's people, you're going to have to be willing to let God change the way you walk. He changed the way He talked. I'll never forget when God delivered me from a filthy mouth. I know you wouldn't believe this, but Jesus knows the truth. Jesus came in,
pero cuando Jesús,
he took my old heart. He gave me a new heart. He changed the way I walk. He changed the way I walk. Words that I looked up.
Una de las palabras que busqué.
I would say,
yo diría,
I think I could safely say,
yo creo que podría decir con
that in this room,
que en este cuarto,
there are people,
hay personas,
not just out in the world,
no solo afuera en el mundo,
but there are people,
pero hay personas,
in this room,
en este cuarto,
who have had bad things happen to you in your youth.
Que has tenido malas cosas que te han sucedido en tu juventud.
Abuse.
Abuso.
Molestation.
Que has sido sexualmente abusado.
Bullying.
Que te han burlado de ti.
Prejudices.
Que han habido prejuicios.
Anger, hatred.
Enojo, odio.
And I probably, the list is so much longer than I'm saying right now.
Y probablemente la lista es mucho más largo de lo que yo estoy diciendo.
They used to have a saying when I was a kid.
Y había un dicho que decía cuando era niño.
Sticks and stones may break my bones.
Palos tal vez podrán quebrar mi cuerpo.
But words will never hurt me.
Pero las palabras nunca me van a
dañar. And that's a lie.
Y esa es una
mentira. That's a lie.
Y esa es una mentira.
More powerful than sticks and stones.
Más poderoso.
Are words.
Que piedras.
Words will cause you to believe or disbelieve.
La palabra te va a causar creer.
Words will cause you to be, have courage or be afraid.
La palabra te va a causar tener ánimo o tener miedo.
And so here we are.
Entonces aquí estamos.
God is about to bring our world to us.
Dios está a punto de traer al mundo.
And they're going to come with addictions.
Y van a venir con adicciones.
And they're going to come from lives just like you have come from.
Y van a venir de vidas de las cuales tú has venido.
Where you have been hurt, you say, why would that happen?
Y tú dirías, ¿por qué esto podría suceder?
This is what Isaiah 61 says.
Esto es lo que Isaías 61 nos dice.
He said the anointing is going to come.
Él dice que la unción va a venir.
To save people out of all of their pain.
Para salvar al pueblo de todos sus dolores.
Out of all of their addictions.
De todas sus adicciones.
Out of all of their brokenness.
De todos sus quebrantamientos.
Out of all of their grief and sorrow.
De todos sus temores y dolores.
Read it. The first three verses.
En los primeros tres versículos.
But then he doesn't stop there.
Pero luego no se detiene
ahí. And he says that he's going to save you out of that stuff.
Y él dice que te va a salvar.
And he's going to say, that's an oak tree. That's an oak tree.
Y te va a decir, este es un árbol.
I planted you.
Yo lo he plantado.
The world did a bad job on you.
El mundo hizo un mal trabajo.
But God says,
pero Dios dice,
I'm going to plant you.
Yo te voy a plantar.
And you're not going to be just like a palm tree.
Y no vas a ser como cualquier otro árbol.
You're going to be like an oak tree.
Vas a ser un árbol fuerte.
You're going to be strong.
Vas a ser fuerte.
You're going to be able to withstand.
Vas a poder sobrepasar.
And he said, because
¿por qué?
Those that God
porque aquellos que Dios
saves out of darkness
libera de las tinieblas
and plants,
y los planta,
he's going to use them.
Les va a usar a ellos.
Hello? Read it. It says, you know, I'm kidding, not right now. Rebuild the waste. Anybody ever heard of generational curses? Somebody said you're going to be like your daddy. How many times I heard that voice in my mind? You're going to turn out like your daddy. Someday you've got to come to a place where you draw a line and say to the devil, I've got a new daddy. I pray I can be like my new daddy. And you got to say, I am going to be like my new father. He said, and we are chosen. There is a purpose for the anointing. To break generational curses. I'm not going to turn out like the past generation. I'm not going to fall down. I'm not going to be the victim. I'm going to be the victor. I'm not going to be the loser. I'm going to be the winner. I'm not going to stay in debt. But the truth is, stinking thinking.
Con pensamientos que huele mal.
Hello? We have been taught not to love one another.
Nos ha enseñado que no debemos de amar a
nosotros. We've been taught to live in, my Lord, I feel the Holy Ghost. We have been taught to live in fear, not only of one another, but of God. The other day we was ministering to a lady in a Bible study. And she was telling us about sicknesses and diseases. And she said, I think God did this to me to punish me. That is stinking thinking. That's a lying devil. Talking to people's mind. God wants to heal you. God wants to save you.
Anointed to cast out devils,
to rebuke spirits of fear,
recover, he better be shaken in his boots. That we're not just chosen to come to church on Sunday. But our steps are ordered. I've got to stop because of time. But I'm telling you, have you ever gotten tired of being like a yo-yo? How do you know what a yo-yo is? It goes up and down, up and down. Haven't you ever thought, God, I don't want to be a yo-yo. I don't want to go up and down. I want to sing like the old timer, Lord, lift me up and let me stand on heaven's tableland. A higher place than I have been. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Haven't you ever wanted to see God perform miracles? Don't you want to be a part of an end time revival? That's going to see blind eyes open, deaf ears unstopped, the dead raised. Don't you want to be a part of a revival that when you lay hands on someone that demons have kept them bound, demons have to flee at the mention of the name of Jesus? Don't you want to be able to say to the addict, you're free? Don't you want to say to the depressed and the suicidal, spirit of depression, leave in Jesus' name? Cry and walk in newness of life. I think in my travels, and I pray it doesn't happen here, that far too many people are willing to sit in the chair or the pew week after week being entertained by music and a pulpit ministry with only a few being bold enough to step out.
Yeah.